Very, very cool. I would love to see, this, like I said, potentially be used to help treat depression, to help treat a lot of
Oh,
different
yes, depression is my next thing.
inflammatory. Yeah.
My wife died because of being schizophrenic, as they say, like no control. And I saw there was no control. I lost her and I have four kids with her. That's the way I began to have interest in scientific studies to show we are able to do so much more. It's in there, it's a soul search. And that's why, that's the way I began.
Do you think that Holland may be more open to this type of treatment? And the reason I say this is because just a couple of days ago, I was at the Van Gogh Museum. I'm a tourist and going to the Van Gogh Museum, and we're all kind of drawn to Van Gogh because he's got this, dark story. He cut off his ear, he
Same
killed
thing.
himself, and
Same thing.
yeah. And as I was reading through, looking at his paintings and reading through, the history behind
The
it, and
emotions and all that, yeah.
yeah. Well,
It's
then
real.
what happened was that he went into this sort of psychiatric hospital, and I thought immediately, oh, they probably put him on drugs. I mean, that's what I thought. As I was reading, it said no, his prescription was two cold baths a day.
Look at that.
And that, I mean, I looked at my husband and I was like, are you kidding me? Is this really, so is that something you think that maybe, because this was in the Netherlands,
Yes, actually, it was in the south of France with Van Gogh. Eh?
Oh, was it in
Van
the
Gogh,
south of France that he was treated? Oh,
but
okay.
he was so depressed, and the light has got a lot of influence on depression.
Yeah.
Melatonin, serotonin,
Serotonin,
the hormone production, etc. So he went to the south of France finally, and then Arles, somewhere south of France, he got into the psychiatric asylum, but they didn't know as well because the cold brings about the alarm cells in the body, which suppresses the cytokine production per direct. But then the breathing
yeah.
even doesn't
More,
move.
yeah. Norepinephrine is increased by the cold, and it suppresses the
You
cytokine production. And
good,
but the epinephrine from the breathing
huh?
does it even more robust. But I was so curious that back in the
Amazing.
late 1800s they were saying
Yes.
cold bath. Why not now? Why not
You were
now?
the first one to tell me he took cold baths. That
Twice a
raises
day
my
he was
respect
prescribed.
for Vincent van Gogh, who was a crazy motherfucker. I'm sorry,
It's
sorry.
okay.
We cannot say that. Okay, but he cut off his ear and then shot himself. And my wife, here like 200 years later, jumped from an eighth floor, having four children. And I'm working with the children right now. And we're having a great company, and we have got a lot of happiness and all that. But then, those days, we had a little, lot of discomfort, discomfort, and no power, and being dependent on all these systems. And that's why I say, yeah, I'm sorry about the F word, but it's the F word, the systems, FD systems. Because we are going to do something about this. And this time we're going to bring back the belief, but also the real chemical connection within the body and the brain toward all the people. And that's regarding depression or any type of mental disorder or physical
Yeah.
disorder.
Yeah, inflammatory disorders in
Yes.
general.
Inflammation, cytokine production. Are we able to tap into that? Yes. Are we able to tap into the vagus nerve? Yes. Are we able to tap into the autonomic nervous system? Yes. I'm sorry. Yes.
Please keep doing what you're doing, and it's awesome. Your passion, your energy, and what you're doing, I respect.
And likewise,
Thank
I
you.
respect your work, which is very good, and it is really needed.